Hey guys, so this is me continuing to talk about my top 10 favorite boss fights in Metal Gear franchise. So already I've listed my number 10, 9, 8, and 7, and 6. So I've listed 5 so far. Half is done, 5 more to go. And I feel like if you guys have watched my other, the previous two videos on this, I get the feeling that you guys are pretty like, wait, what? Like, those are your choices? Those are so weird. But these are my choices. I gave you my rationale for it. It's a highly debatable list. You know, everyone has a different list of like different experiences with these boss fights. Metal Gear Solid, as a franchise as a whole, has pretty amazing boss fights. I've mentioned to you before that I haven't played Rising myself, and I feel like this list would be very different if I had played Metal Gear Rising: Revengeance. It might just be that, like, because I've watched the boss fights in the Let's Play, they look freaking amazing. I just feel like maybe if I played Rising, most of this list will be bosses from Metal Gear Rising. I don't know. I have no idea. But anyway, let's continue. So, number 5 for me is fighting against Metal Gear Ray while piloting a Metal Gear Rex in Metal Gear Solid 4. That was just, I don't know, I think that was always a fan dream of many Metal Gear fans, including me. You know, after fighting against Rex, like I said before in the previous video, Rex is what I think of. When I think of Metal Gear, the first picture that comes to mind is Metal Gear Rex. In Metal Gear Solid 4, you finally get to control it. Albeit is a beaten down, worn down version of it, but you're using this clunky, wonky, walking battle tank with a railgun missing, and you're using it, piloting it, fighting against an anti-Metal Gear Ray. So the odds are stacked against you, and it's amazing. I don't know. Like, the boss fight is, again, highly replayable, and the sequence itself also includes close quarters mech combat, so you can get in. You could dash to Metal Gear Ray and slam it, jump on it, and shoot a laser beam to it. Like, that's mech battle CQC. Holy crap. You know, I get so excited talking about this. Like, oh, I'm piloting a Rex and beating up a Ray. A Metal Gear versus an anti-Metal Gear. And just that experience, oh man, it's so great. I just loved that experience so much. It's just like, that is total fan service, and I totally bought into it. Many people, I don't know, I just loved it. That's just my opinion, and that's why it's number 5 for me, just because of the pure enjoyment and excitement that I've had with this boss fight. I was so much more excited and engaged in this boss fight than most other boss fights. There's no, like, emotional impact to it, you know? It's just like, you're fighting Metal Gear Ray as Rex. I mean, there's not too much to say about that other than that. You're fighting Metal Gear Ray using a Metal Gear Rex. Yeah. Number 4 for me. Gray Fox. You fight against him in Metal Gear Solid 1. You also fight against Null in Portable Ops, but that boss fight for me, didn't really do it for me. I also don't like Null's character design at all, but that's a different topic altogether. Gray Fox. Hand-to-hand combat, done in a large area where you're, you know, it's one of my most memorable boss fights in the series. Because Gray Fox has a character design, one of the most coolest characters ever, so mysterious. We hardly know anything about Gray Fox, even to this day, which is weird, because he's mentioned as Null in Portable Ops, and there's all these allusions to Gray Fox. We still don't know, and Gray Fox is also a character in Metal Gear 1 who teaches, pretty much shows Snake the ropes of becoming an awesome soldier. You know, he's this mysterious, awesome, badass character who does some terrible things in his life. And he's the reason why Naomi becomes the way she is, so bent on revenge against Solid Snake. And then in the end, ultimately being the one to build the foundation for Fox Alive, and pretty much the architect of Fox Die, you know. But anyway, that's the story aspect of it. Gray Fox is a very mysterious, amazing character, but the fight itself is pretty damn cool. Like, just you know, he's just flipping around, and you're like, how the hell do I fight against this guy who uses stealth technology and wields a blade and jumps around like crazy, but he has honor in that he's just like, hand to hand, Solid Snake. And you fight him hand to hand, you can piss him off actually. If you use a shaft grenade and you use weapons against him, he gets so pissed off and he's like, fine, you know, you're gonna play it that way, I'll play it my way. He starts using his blade, it gets like super difficult. But he's a very pained individual when you fight him. You know, he's like, hurt me more. You know, he wants that pain. He wants to be defeated in a way. His last dying wish is to fight Solid Snake man to man. And whether he die or whether Solid Snake dies, that's his final wish. And there's something about a character who's gone to that brink of just at that state, at that psychological level, and playing, you know, and fighting against this guy is like, what, why? Like, why is he doing this? Why is he even here? What's his purpose in here? Because he's not tied to Foxhound Unit. He's not tied to anything. He has no ideology. He's just here because he wants to do battle. And I think that's one of the most amazing concepts about Gray Fox. You know, he also scares the shit out of, you know, Otacon. He pisses in his pants, you know, because of it. And then you realize later on, you know, like, he without Gray Fox in the end, Solid Snake probably would have been defeated by Metal Gear Rex, you know. And the code name Fox is so important, you know. He's the only person in history to have the code name Fox. And he makes one of the most memorable quotes. But that's the character himself. I think perhaps I put too much emotional attachment to the character when thinking of this boss fight. But the boss fight itself is extremely fun. If you played in extreme difficulty, man, this boss fight can be pretty intense. Because his moves are different in the higher difficulty. That's what I also love about Metal Gear Solid games. The higher difficulty doesn't just mean, like many other games, like, oh yeah, enemies have more damage, and you take less, if you take a few hits, then you die. That's kind of the difference in most games. In Metal Gear Solid, higher the difficulty changes a lot. No radar, for example. And the enemy patrols, they have different patrol routes. Like, higher difficulty changes a lot of things, and it changes the boss fight of Gray Fox. Well, the original does. Twin Snakes doesn't do that. Twin Snakes boss fight is still fun, but I would stand by the original on this one. The original boss fight against Gray Fox, one of my favorite boss fights ever. And I'll end the video here. My next video, I'm going to talk about my top three boss fights. And I think they're going to be pretty obvious because I haven't mentioned a lot. You know, I feel like you could pretty much guess who those three are going to be. And I feel like maybe my top three mini Metal Gear fans will agree with me. My top 10 through 4, I feel like some of you guys are going like, what? Like, really? That's your top 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4? Okay. But this is my rationale for it. My top 3, I feel like they're going to be pretty obvious choices. But anyway, stay tuned for the next video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.